proper functioning of the thyroid is critical. However, there can be certain conditions that cause the thyroid to be dysfunctional. And one of these conditions can be known as hyperthyroidism, or a hyperactive thyroid. That can be caused by a few different ways. And one of the most common is an autoimmune condition known as Graves' disease. However, a hyperactive thyroid can also be caused by subacute thyroiditis, and it can also be caused by a toxic nodule or toxic nodules that are present on the thyroid gland. Now, as a brief refresher, the pituitary gland in the brain releases thyroid-stimulating hormone, and this is a start signal to the thyroid gland to release two primary hormones, T4 and T3. Once those hormone levels rise back in the body, this actually sends a stop signal back to the pituitary gland to reduce the amount of thyroid-stimulating hormone being released. However, during a hyperactive thyroid condition, the thyroid gland is actually getting an additional stimuli. This could be from thyroid-stimulating antibodies that are telling it to release more and more hormones. So we see that T4 and T3 hormones in the body actually rise, but the pituitary gland notices that these levels are rising and it's trying to decrease the amount of thyroid-stimulating hormone being released. So we see TSH levels decrease in the body. But again, because that thyroid gland is getting additional stimuli, the T4 and T3 levels in the body do not go back down. Now, this can cause a variety of different symptoms. Some of these include fatigue or weight loss. It can also include insomnia or intolerance to heat and much more. So if you want to know more about hyperthyroidism and about the thyroid in general, make sure to check the link in the video description below.